Good afternoon, everybody. It is shopping day. I have a Walmart haul to put up to let you see. If you've seen the previous video, it was the Aldi's haul. I'm gonna make it a two-part video. So here we go with Walmart. Now, all you guys know that I am a wildlife lover. I enjoy watching my wildlife, even though I have a group of birds. I call them starlings. I don't know if they are starlings. They're little black birds with yellow bills. I sometimes just call them yellow bill. If you watch Supernatural, you know in the beginning of the series they had a demon called Yellow Eyes. Well, that's what I call my bird, my yellow-billed birds, my little demons. But got a case of suet cakes for my birdies. There are about 8 suet cakes in here. Each suet cake, if the yellow bills don't come still at all, can last a couple of days, almost a week. I watch my Missouri bluebird. I've got woodpeckers. I've got finches. I even got a cardinal or two who come to my suet cake. Granted, I have a regular wild bird feeder with seed in it for the finches and the smaller birds, but it seems like mostly my woodpeckers and one or two varieties of finch, or not finch, excuse me, I'll take that back, chickadee will come to my wild bird feeder. So will the yellow bills, but I chase them off as best I can. I have cut back a lot on my soda consumption. Usually it's like one or two 12-ounce cans at the house, or one of the 16-ounce bottles. At work, when I'm there, it's basically either a 16-ounce bottle or the 24-ounce bottle if we have it. And then once I drink that at work, it's either iced tea or water. The water is actually ice water. It's free because the water comes straight out of my tap. If you watch my Aldi haul that I did earlier today, I got paper plates from Aldi's, but I also got the Great Value brand because I forgot to check it off on the Walmart list because I was trying to get some stuff from Walmart that I couldn't get at Aldi's because Aldi's was almost picked clean. In fact, I think when I was in Aldi's, there was maybe, not including workers, 8, 10, maybe 12 people total in the store. And all the stores here in Rolla have got on their floors and on their walls signs saying, please do social distancing, 6 feet separation, which I thought was great because a lot of the customers were following that practice. When we were standing in line, there's markers on the floor for where we can stand to the closest person at the register to the person next in line. There were like markers where we could stand, which I thought was great. I know my sister's store in town, the one off of 72, the Casey's off 72, they've already got sneeze guards in front of the registers, in between the register and the customer, because not all the customers are listening to stand behind that black line, please, because that's the 6-foot distance. I saw on my, well, within the information that my manager is leaving out for us to look at, that there was a sign that she put in an envelope. I caught a glimpse of it saying, sorry, we are temporarily closed for cleaning. I'm guessing that's so they have the time to put up the sneeze guard and let all the glues and whatnot set so it doesn't collapse on us or our customer. Anyhow, let's continue with the haul. Excuse me, I'm getting a little bit of a dry throat. Let me try to pull out one of the bags of bags. If I can do this without hurting my wrist. Okay, oh yeah, no wonder this is heavy. It had two big items in it. At Aldi's, Jerry had asked me to try to find her the Jif Natural Creamy. Well, Aldi's didn't have any, literally any, regular peanut butter. So I got her a big jar, her standard size jar of the Jif All Natural Creamy. So she should be very happy about that. Just to make sure I had enough, I bought my big bottle of honey. This beauty lasts a long time. It lasts good, maybe a month and a half, because I use this primarily for my morning tea or when I drink my teas. The reason why is I'm trying to cut back on sugars. Well, tea is a natural flavor. It's not, does not have as much, well, what is this? 1 tablespoon of this honey has 16 grams of sugar. Well, 16 grams of sugar in 1 tablespoon of this equals half of regular sugar, if I'm memorizing my math correctly, which I may or may not, I don't know. But one of the things I saw, and again, Walmart was picked clean of cereal bars, but I found a mixed berry fruit and grain cereal bar. I like this because this is a healthy, quick snack. I can actually take, didn't even have to get up, just had to look, he flew off. I can take one of these to work as a snack and not have to worry about spending money for something to munch on when 90% of the stuff that I have in my store for me to munch on is not really all that great. Before I forget, Mom needed her thing of kitty litter for Miss Carmen. Miss Carmen is her cat. She does let me pet her. At first when we met, she was unsure of who I was, and like all cats, when they're unsure of something, they hiss at it. I had come back here in 2010 trying to get a job, hopefully to get Jerry Ann to move out of here before we even knew about Sandy, but before Sandy hit. And that's when I first met Carmen, and she wasn't exactly happy with me because the room that I was sleeping in, which was like an enclosed porch, was her space. Basically, she would go in there to sit in the window and watch things and all that kind of fun stuff. But after letting her come into the room with all my stuff and letting me, and there was a couple of nights where it got so warm that I ended up bringing my air mattress into the house to sleep in the living room. And well, Mom at the time left the house open for her because she didn't want to close all the doors. I woke up one morning and found Carmen sleeping at the foot of the bed, like on the bed, sleeping, just laying there. And that's how she got used to me. I wish she would have the same getting used to with Jerry Ann, but at least she's not hissing at Jerry Ann when Jerry Ann goes to let her into Mom's room or open up the Arcadia door for ventilation or whatever. But yes, I get sidetracked easily. I have what I call wild brain, which basically means my brain is everywhere. I try to look for chicken thighs at Aldi's. They were out of chicken. They were out of just about most, if not all, their meats. But Jan asked me to get some boneless, skinless chicken thighs, which I got a nice pack of them. She can split them up to how many, whatever she wants to split them up. She uses these chicken, she found a recipe that she uses chicken thigh. And basically what it is she shreds the, she cooks, then shreds the chicken thighs, and then put it in our slow cooker, our crock pot, whatever you want to call it, to make the most delicious, and I don't know where she got the recipe, but the most delicious chicken enchilada. So, had to get these. Then, because of the fact that we do not have any ground beef, we have one package, 1 2-pound package of ground beef that we use to make meatloaf. So I got another, and this was the only size ground beef that they had available in the largest pack. And it is a 4.5-pound package of ground beef, which we can take and section this off into, can't remember if she does it in 6 or 4, but we can section it off, roll it out, flatten it out, put it in a freezer Ziploc bag, freeze it, and anytime we want to make like hamburger helper or something that only calls for about 1 pound of ground beef, boom, it's already there. We don't have to worry about defrosting it, cutting it, and hopefully it doesn't spoil. So those are two of the cool things that I need to try to get into my overstuffed refrigerator. Good luck. Luckily, the house is cool enough and the temperature outside is cool enough and the house is open up that I don't have to worry about getting all this stuff in the freezer now. It can wait a few minutes. But Mom's running low on regular crinkle fries, so I bought a thing of crinkle fries. JM wanted me to buy a thing of sweet potato fries, but Aldi's and Walmart were out. We're thinking about, might not be able to do it today, but we were thinking about going back out to check Price Chopper for some of the things that we did not get. I got some microwavable sweet corn and microwavable whole kernel, just regular corn. The reason why two is I like the sweet corn. I don't know if Jay is supposed to have it or not, so I got the regular. What we've done in the past with canned corn, and this was canned sweet corn, whole kernel, and canned cream corn, regular. We would make the two and mix the two together. So, because I'm not a big fan of cream corn, but I will eat it. Cream corn, oh, bluebird. Sorry. Cream corn is one of those things where my dad really didn't make it because he didn't like it. The only thing I ever remember my father using creamed corn for was to mix it into cornbread batter to make sweet cornbread. And he used muffin tins. We used muffin tins. But it's good that way. I also got a thing of green beans. The reason why I got frozen green beans instead of fresh is because, one, Aldi's was out of the fresh green beans. And two, for some reason, every time we get Aldi's fresh cut green beans that basically are not frozen, they go bad quickly. The last time we got a pack, it was maybe 3 or 4 days after we got them and we pulled them out of the refrigerator to make them, basically. And the whole bottom, luckily it was not out of the bag, but you can see it in the bag, the whole bottom was just fuzz from the mold and mildew. And I know it's not from our refrigerator because the first time it happened, we gave the crisper drawer and the whole bottom section of the refrigerator a thorough disinfecting cleaning. So I know it's not the refrigerator. It's got to be something to do with the produce. I don't know. But anyhow, since we're going on the possibility of being locked down, I only got one package because they only had one package left of the Black Forest ham from Walmart. It's one of my favorite go-to hams. We have deli sliced Black Forest ham that I need to check to make sure it's still good. And if it is, eat it. Make sure that bag that I just got is towards the back of the crisper. And then, just to make sure Mom had enough, I got 5 bottles of Mom's Coke just to ensure that she's got enough. Because I think she got maybe guesstimation around 8 to 10 still, but she drinks 1 liter within like a day and a half. So that in effect of what she does is she'll like take a liter out of the refrigerator, take it in the bedroom, drink it until it gets too warm or whatnot, brings it back in, and basically she'll like switch them out. So she might not drink a whole bottle in one setting, but she'll drink at least a bottle and a half in a day, day and a half. Next bag. Move some stuff around so I don't overwhelm myself with products. Try not to push on those because those are eggs. Don't want them to go over the edge. They're gonna be scrambled egg night. That's a receipt from there. Jerry won't want that. Something I haven't seen in a long time, and I love them because I remember them from Germany, was the, and it wasn't even this company, it was a German company, but I can't get the German brand here in the States. Pecorage Farm makes a great apricot raspberry thumbprint cookie is what I call them. They call them sweet and simple thumb bread cookies. So there we go. I know these will be mine because not very many people in this house likes raspberry or the flavoring of raspberry. I do believe these are for mom, but I'm not 100% because I think all three of us take it. It's a twin pack, 500 milligram of niacin. It's good for your metabolic support. It's a metabolic support pill, medicine, whatever you want to call it. And then, because I still haven't tried it yet, and I didn't want to get too many because they seem to go bad before I eat them all. There are only four here, but they're bananas, and hopefully tonight I'll make myself a smoothie. There will probably be enough smoothie for Jan to try. If not, I'll just have enough to store for later. I'm trying not to make too much that has to go in the refrigerator because, like I said, right now our refrigerator is packed. And I'm probably going to have to go in there and rearrange some stuff and all that just to get everything in there. This will probably go in the freezer, but Mom likes her egg whites, so when we go to make eggs for our meal of the day, our family meal, I'm going to call it the family meal because Jenny-Ann eats a meal by herself. I eat a meal by myself. Sometimes the only meal we eat together is the one meal before I go to work on my work days. But anyhow, that's for her. That's probably going to go in the freezer. Jerry requested, because I guess she's out. I hope this is the right stuff. She said brown mustard. The only brown mustard I know of is spicy brown. So Golden's, I know she likes it. I'm pretty sure she's eaten it. She eats it. If not, my bad. Should have thought about the size of this before I bought it, but because I know both me and Jerry Ann eat it, me and Jerry Ann will both eat it. It is, well, it's a vegetable product, even though it's got some things that aren't that great for you, like sugars. And it does not even have a nutritional tag, which is surprising. But it's basically 1 pound worth of coleslaw. And because we have fish patties, and that's a side item for a lot of our late night meals, because I get home, now that I get home at a little bit after 10, we're not eating like really, really close to midnight, but we both eat something when I come home. And then we stay up for a couple of hours to let our food settle before going to bed. So it's a nice little, like, instead of making a whole meal and whatnot, let's just have sandwiches with coleslaw and potato salad as side dishes. Anyhow, we were running low. I thought I got, oh no, I know what, I remember what I did. We have maybe one stick of Kerrygold butter left.
No, that's not good. Not good. Not good.
So, of course, at Walmart, since Ollie's didn't have it, I got a 2-stick package of Kerrygold plus the Kerrygold spreadable dish type deal. I'm sorry. I am spoiled. I love my Kerrygold. I know it's a $5 package brand, or almost $5 package brand, but you can't go wrong with the Irish. I know there might be a couple people out there going, oh yes you can. Try to say that to an Irishman and see how fast you get beaten. I did say this in my last Ollie call. I accidentally, because I forgot to cross it off, same with the paper plates, I accidentally got a second thing of, and this is Cascade. The other one was an off-brand, but this is Cascade with Oxy. Yeah, Oxy and Dawn. So, we have enough dish tabs to last us a while. Granted, we do dishes maybe once every other day. Yeah, about every other day. The other thing, because I knew we were running low on, was I got Jet Dry for basically the dishwasher. But now that I'm looking at the other dish tabs and these dish tabs, you don't really need the Jet Dry, because they have, the way they're designed, the tabs are designed, it has your powder dishwashing soap, then it has your stain fighting dishwasher soap and your cleaning dishwasher, and then your Jet Dry. Get! See?
Yeah.
Nothing. Yelling at the bird. Oh. Jan's falling asleep out in the living room. That's fine. She does her best. She goes through these days where she crafts like a madman. She just goes nuts crafting and crafting and crafting and continues crafting until she hurts. And then the next day, after all her crafting and doing her videos and whatnot, she is wiped out. And I can understand, because I have the same thing. I have days where I wake up and I'm just full of vim and vigor, and I'm just going a mile a minute, and blah, 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 just going and going and going and going. And by the time it's time to go to bed, or it's basically towards the end of the day and I have nothing else to do, I either fall asleep and take a cat nap on the recliner, or that night I crash. I mean, I like, boom, I'm gone. I'm down for the count. And then I sleep until... There was one day that I did that where I just like, I mean, I just went at it like a crazy person and crashed real hard that night and didn't wake up. And I literally slept. Jenny Ann said basically I slept for almost 13 hours straight, nonstop, no waking up to go pee, no nothing. And I was just like, oh, wow, I must have really overdid it the day before. That's what's happened today. Today, Jerianne, overdid it last night. She really did a great job. She did like, I don't know, it must have been like 8 to 10 hours worth of crafting while I was at work. And then I told her she didn't have to come shopping with me, but she was the driver. Took mom, got mom some of her stuff from CVS and one of the other grocery stores, and then she drove to Aldi's and Walmart, and I went inside and I did all the shopping. So she's crashing. It's all right. Today was going to be our relaxational go shopping and plan out the 10-day vacation. I'll be here to do whatever. But anyhow, we needed the flushable wipes. Walmart did have a sign saying, please limit yourself to one. But the lady who was putting them out as I went to get them told me, because I was on the phone with Jerry and saying, the sign says, please limit yourself one. And the lady next to me, after I got done talking to Jerry, said, you can take a second one. We just don't want people buying half a shelf worth of wipes. So I got two. Which was great because we do kind of go through these. I mean, I use them just to make sure I'm clean down there after I go number two. Sometimes when I'm having an irritation, I'll use one to try to clean up the irritation so I can put cream. 48 years old and I'm creaming myself. I'm using cream for irritations in places I never thought I'd get an irritation. Yes, folks, there's still more to come. Last time I went shopping by myself, which I'm learning that I either need to go shopping or learn how to control myself. Oh no, they got smashed. Oh, well, that's just one out of a package. Got myself some of the pre-sliced pound cake. Lemon, blueberry, and banana nut. I love them. I wanted some more, and I figured it's a treat. I will try to do my best not to eat half the package within a 2-day period of time. Not good. Because all these was out of Mom's cheese Danish, and Mom has been looking for cheese Danish for, oh, I'd say a month. The last thing of cheese Danish we got her, we got two packages, and before we even got into the first package, we noticed that they were dry and had little itty bitty but noticeable mold spots starting to form. So we ended up tossing two packages worth of cheese Danish for Mom. Well, I'm hoping Mom likes this because, granted, it's only 4-pack. They're individual. She can put each one of them into a freezer bag and freeze them without having to worry about cutting into them and then freezing individual. They're already individual, but they're cute. They're yummy looking cheese Danish from Walmart. I'm hoping, by the looks of things, they are nice and fresh, and I gotta put them aside or else I'll eat one. Those are from Mom, so I don't want to eat them. Last bag, I promise. Just move stuff around so I can get to it. Alrighty. You saw the stems, you're like, oh no, what is it? Jerry needed some more lamb's ear, so she asked me to get a bundle or two sprigs, whatever you want to call that. There's like 4 stems, so 4 individual things of lamb's ear. She used, I wouldn't say she used all, but she used most of the lamb's ear that we bought her last time we went shopping on her Easter DIY. Lamb's ear is a great Easter DIY decor piece. Whether you use the lamb's ear in a floral vase, vase decor, or use them as part of her, darn, I don't know where they went, but she made a wreath or two with lamb's ear. So it's, you know, I'm not going to complain that she's getting it because she does use it. I complain sometimes when she gets it and it's like, what are you going to do with it? Because I'm the type of person who, if I'm going to buy something, I'm buying something because I know what I'm going to use it for. I don't buy it just because I may or may not need it, but that's me. I'm not a crafter. I'm not a real big DIY person. If anything that I was going to do to put in a video, it would be 1 or 2 items that I cook that I'm the cook of. I am the person who, hey, Jim, let's make teriyaki beef. No problem. This is what I need. Throw it all together. Do what I have to do. And basically, it's whatever. If there's a side vegetable, I might do it. If there's rice, I'll do that. But like beef teriyaki, my homemade chili mac, a few little things that come out of my brain that go, oh, this sounds great, let's make it. Okay, it tastes great, let's try to remember it. One of the dishes that my dad discovered while he was stationed in Thailand when I was a baby, It's a dish called cow pot. Sounds really weird. Tastes great. And all it is, it's beef that's been marinated and cooked, ground beef that's been marinated in soy sauce and garlic and onion powder and I can't remember it all off the top of my head, but one of the items in cow pot is basically, it's almost like taking and making ground stir-fried beef. It's almost got the same ingredients. It's got the beef, it's got the seasoning, it's got the rice, it's got a scrambled egg, but there's one ingredient which you cannot find in the United States, and I've tried to mimic it with certain Asiatic vegetables. It's called klung weed. Basically what it is, it's a weed that literally grows out of the irrigation ditches in Thailand. And surprisingly enough, it's considered edible. I personally would not eat it if I knew what it was and saw it. I know what that is, get it out of my face. But my dad didn't have anything like that, so what he would use is chopped greens, chives, that's what it was. Chopped up chives, fresh chives that he chopped up and threw in there. Granted, mom still is, I'm not that picky, but we were picky. So to find something green in our food would be like, pick it out. I would pick peas out of my food. I would pick anything that did not look like something I would want to stick in my mouth, I would pick it out of the food. I'm not that bad anymore. Joanne wanted bagels. Unfortunately, I could not find any other G-free bagels because Aldi's was out, and Aldi's is the only place that I know that have G-free products. But I wanted bagels. So, I'm not trying to be mean to Jerry because, Victor, I found bagels I want even though they're not G-free. I got cinnamon swirl bagels. I have, not only do I have to carry gold to put on this, but we had gotten the honey walnut spread from Panera when we went to get some bagels and whatnot. Granted, we weren't able to go inside. They actually said I can go around to get my order, and I went, well, can I just grab it and go now since it's already been paid for? And they're like, oh yeah, what's the name? That was the day that the Panera Bread decided they were just going to close their doors. In fact, a lot of places at that time were closing their doors to lobby people, but you can do your drive-through pickup and whatnot. A lot of places have done that. Some of them, probably a lot of them, are not hurting as badly, but to think about all the people who normally go into a restaurant and they work the lobby, they're the hostess, they're the person who's in the lobby the most, the bartender, whatnot. Those poor souls are currently out of work because of this whole thing, and I feel for them. Thankfully, a lot of the good companies are like, look, we'll give you X amount of dollars plus allow you an unemployment check for X amount of dollars for the duration of this temporary layoff. So I'm happy a lot of companies are doing that. Continuing on. The first thing I'm going to show you is one of my favorite healthy snacks, even though you're probably going to go, how can you consider that healthy because it's got honey? Peanut butter and honey crackers. I can take one of these to work, and that will like carry me over for the 8-9 hours that I have to work. So, it was something I considered a necessity. Even though I'm not liking how these breads are coming out, and I don't know if that's just the way I grab it or what. But I think that's the second loaf of bread that looked like the tab was not on the right. Anyhow, I could not find the regular sourdough bread that we normally get. And this is about the same cut as the loaves that we normally get, but I think it's slightly less. But now that I'm looking at the loaf, and I'll show you what I mean here in a second, I can probably cut the loaf in half or the slice of bread in half and make a decent-sized sandwich. But I got the store brand, or the fresh-made, store-made sourdough bread. And as you can see, it's a fairly good-sized slice. Like I was saying, I could probably cut that in half and make it a decent sandwich, a decent regular sliced sandwich. But it's what they had. They didn't have any regular sourdough, pre-made, shipped-in type. This is the in-store bread that basically it's got a tag on here saying that if it's best used by the 9th of November, the 9th of April, which is 7 days away. I don't think I'll have a problem eating this whole loaf in 7 days. I will try not to, but I don't think I'll have a problem doing it. Down to the last bag, last of it, it's almost done. And this video naturally went by longer than normal. With mom's cat litter, she always asks for kitty litter liners. And these are great because the factor, even if you've got multiple cats, these will fit your average size cat litter pan. They're pretty durable. Carmen has not ripped through them. Granted, Carmen does not have her front claws. She only has her back claws. But for your average cat, your average indoor cat, if it still has its claws, I don't think the cat will rip through this easily. At least that's what they say. It says rip proof, but I've had cats in the past with claws, and they can rip through these, especially if they're scratching and clawing in the same place constantly. The bag will eventually tear. So it's like one of those. I'll take it with a grain of salt. Now, I don't know if Jerry wanted me to get these because she uses a lot of plastic spoons, but she said get the assorted pack. At least I think she said assorted pack. So there is 32 forks, 32 knives, and 32 spoons of plastic cutlery, 96 in all. So, I mean, for those of you who either A, don't want to do dishes constantly because of the virus, or B, would rather use plastic utensils when you get takeout or order in. A lot of places that give you takeout or order in are basically pick up or takeout, give you plastic utensils. So I don't know if this is like, let's get plastic utensils to use on our, the dishwasher is full, I don't want to make any more dishes until we run it and empty it type days or what. But I got what she wanted. And for those of you who watched my Aldi haul from today, haul part one, I had gotten Ziploc bags. What I did not get was the vacuum Ziploc bag. So when I went to Walmart, forgetting that I got regular Ziploc bags and could not find the vacuum Ziploc bags, and maybe I was looking in the wrong place. I don't know. Jerry will probably tell me when I talk to her about it. So I just got the Power Shield Technology Unbeatable Protection Gallon Size and Quart Size Zipper Bags. Now, it's 20 gallon and 25 quart. So we have enough Ziploc bags to last us for a while. Now, we don't go through Ziploc bags like crazy because most of the time the Ziploc bags, the gallon size Ziploc bags, are used for our freezer stuff or our large stuff like leftover pizzas from pizza night. So the gallon size bag, we put like the chicken cutlets, the quartered or divided ground beef packs we take the ground beef packs and we kind of flatten it out by hand so it becomes a flat package so we can stand it up and lean it against the wall, the back wall of the freezer, so all our meat products that are in the Ziploc bags line up like this. So I can go in there and go, okay, here's chicken cutlets, or here's some ground beef, or here's pork chops, or whatever I go in there. It's easier to look through instead of them being on top of each other like this. They're more like this. But that's the way we do it here at the house. It makes things a whole lot easier to find, less frustration with stuff trying to come out of the freezer as you're trying to pull a package of ground beef from underneath a package of whatever, or whatever, however the stack is. That's just the way we try to do things to make it so, so much easier on everybody, and nobody's getting mad at each other because, where's the ground beef? Where did that chicken cutlet go? I'm tired of pulling out stacks and having it fall on my foot. Those are some of the things I've said. Because out of love and respect for my wife, I try to make it easier on her because of her mobility issues by being the gopher. And yes, I said the word gopher. Anyhow, that concludes the shopping haul. It's actually starting to get cool in the house from the factor that it looks like we're getting storm clouds. And it is, it's not early enough to be getting this dark, but they did put out a warning. The Weather Channel put out a warning last night about severe storms approaching our area for the weekend. Well, it's Thursday. It's not the weekend yet. So, but you can't control Mother Nature. Mother Nature will do whatever she wills and feels like doing. And if we don't like it, well, tough tushy. Anyhow, that is today's shopping haul. I'm not going to show it. I'm going to just tell you about it. Both Jerry Ann and I both got a wish package each today. The wish package she got that came in her name was actually supposed to be for me. They're French cufflinks. If you know what French cufflinks are, French cut shirts. They have the hole where the button usually is, but instead it's two holes that you put a cufflink in. They are, and I might show it on a different vehicle. Going good, Jim. I might show it on a different haul, entitled Wish Haul. But anyhow, they got the Star Trek symbol with like, what looks like the Milky Way behind it. Darn it, I actually forgot what I got. That's how impressive her gift was, that I forgot what I got. Maybe that's not a bad thing, because I should be thinking more about what she got me over what I got myself. So, like I said, I'll probably show the cufflinks in a different haul, because this is almost 40. I took my glasses off. Wait! Almost 45 minutes. Yeah, almost 45 minutes long. So, I knew not to put Walmart and all these together because of the length. If you've actually watched this from beginning to end, wow, I'm going to give you some kudos, because I don't know how boring shopping hauls are or not. I don't know how many shopping hauls y'all watch, or how long Jerry Ann's shopping hauls can be. And I don't put prices, because I know from various location to location, not everything is the same. Bread, milk, and other products might be higher in bigger cities, or even closer to St. Louis if you live in Missouri, compared to, or even California prices, compared to New York prices, compared to Texas, compared to St. Louis, compared to any part of the country. I know a lot of places like Walmart, all these might have the same prices no matter where you go. Don't know. I don't worry about the prices, because when you need the food, the price doesn't matter. You buy it anyhow. But that's just me. Anywho, if you enjoyed this and you thought it was good, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't think it was good, or you don't like it, or you just don't like me for one reason or another, don't even put a thumbs down. Don't even worry about it. Just chill out. It's Jim doing another video. I'm going to skip to somebody else. Please do that. Because if you're going to be negative, you're going to be putting thumbs down. I don't want to deal with it. I deal with enough negativity at my job. There's enough negativity in the world, period. I don't want it. I deal with what I have to. But since this is my channel, I don't have to. If you have questions or comments, positive, please go ahead and put them in the comment section. If you're new to my channel and you want to see more hauls, or maybe if you've watched other videos, maybe you've watched some of my wish hauls, maybe you've watched some of my just general vlogs where I'm just chatting about everything, maybe you've watched some of my Bible study haul, Bible study vlogs, and you want to see some more of that, hit the bell and tell me. Tell me you want to see me do more Bible study. Tell me you enjoy the other videos. That's fine and dandy. I like hearing some of your comments. I like hearing some of your suggestions. The suggestions that I will ignore the quickest is anything to do with this or anything to do with this. Because I'm doing what I'm doing for a purpose, and I don't care what the world thinks of it. So, anything negative about my wife is off limits. Anyhow, God bless and have a good day.